morning, everyone. Welcome back to Poorboys Little Homestead. As always, if this is your first time here, thanks for dropping in. Feel free to drop in anytime you feel, my friend. Guys, today, my neighbor asked me to help her clean up some of her trees she wanted trimmed up. And I've done a review on this electric Worx pole saw, and I'll try to attach it above somewhere in this video in case y'all want to go back and watch it. But during that review, I really didn't have no footage of me using it. So I'm going to show y'all exactly what this little Worx pole saw would do. It's electric, and I got my little Honda 2800 generator sitting here in the back of my truck. That way I can just back up here. I'll start cutting these limbs on this little tree line, and I'll pull my truck up and work that way. But I got the Worx chainsaw, and I got the Worx 10-inch pole saw here. So let's get to work. I'm going to show y'all what we got to do. So we got a tree line right here. She wants these trimmed up a little bit and try to get her place out of him bush hogged and cleaned up a little bit. And this tree line runs right on down through there, right on into her yard, into her house. So I got a good bit of tree limbs to be cutting today. Ain't none of them really that big, just small. We're gonna trim them off, and then we're gonna bring our tractor back, and she's got some dirt to spread. And now I take my tractor and pick all the limbs up and put them in her pile out here where she wants them. So let's see if we can get to work this morning while it's cool.
Thank you.
guys, as y'all can see, the little Worx 10-inch electric pole saw will get the job done. Now, of course, when you're doing a lot like this, it would be nice to have the pole saw, the gas-operated pole saw. But if you're just a homeowner, got a few limbs you're going to trim, then it may be a year before you need it again or longer. That's why I purchased that electric pole saw. When I was working off, I had a gas-operated weed eater, a gas pole saw, and a gas chainsaw. I'd stay gone so long when I'd come in to use it, they never would crank. Finally, one day, the weed eater slash pole saw, it was an off-brand. So I fooled with it two or three times, got it back running. Then one day I'd come in and I just threw it to the trash. Now my chainsaw was a steel, so I gave it to a friend of mine so he could use it and one he had to put together and get one running out of the two. And I just purchased this Worx chainsaw, and I'll show y'all a clip of that of me using the Worx chainsaw. And it's nice. I usually don't trim this much at one time. I'm just doing this for my neighbor, but just to trim around my house and stuff, guys, they really work. Now you gotta be easy with them. They are, you can't be as rough and hard. You gotta let them eat on their own. Don't try to force them through the limb, for they are plastic operated gears inside, not metal gears. But I've done a lot of cutting with that little Worx 10-inch. I've done enough cutting with that Worx pole saw and that Worx chainsaw, guys, that if it quit today, I wouldn't complain. For the price I give for it, and as much as I've cut with it already, it really surprised me. It's way outdone what my expectations was for it when I bought it. But we're gonna move on down. We got about this much further to go, but it ain't but just some smaller limbs. There's some more limbs on this that need it cut, but I can't reach that high, and I just told the lady I would get as high as I could reach, that I wasn't gonna get on no ladder or nothing, and she said that was fine, she understood. This ain't nothing out here, she just wants it cleaned up a little bit so she can, I guess, start mowing this road frontage area right here. And like I said, I'm gonna bring my tractor back with my forks and I clean all this up on my landscape rake. And got some dirt y'all might be able to see in the background over there to spread far, but I'll clean this up at a later date. But right now I just wanted to give y'all a little video of the Worx chainsaw and pole saw and how they work. Here in just a little bit I'll show y'all the chainsaw, and like I said, I'm going to add a clip in to where I was using it just a few days ago cutting with the Worx chainsaw. Now guys, another cool option about this pole saw, and it extends up there to about 10 foot long. It's 120 volts. But one of the cool options about it is you can remove the saw right here. From the pole, and then you got your lightweight 10-inch electric chainsaw. And guys, it is very handy. Very, very handy. Now the other one I got here is the Worx 18-inch chainsaw, and like I said, I'm gonna attach a video of me previously using this. And guys, I've cut some pretty good sized trees, which I don't think I have a video of, but I cut some pretty good sized trees. And it ain't that I was cutting them up for wood. I had some I wanted to remove, and I cut them, and then like cut them in half, and then drug them off with the tractor, and then someone else come by and cut them up for firewood. But these two little saws has really amazed me on what they'll do for a little electric saw. Now again, I ain't trying to put them up there with no steel chainsaw. They ain't like that. They slower cutting. Like I said, you gotta let them feed on their own. Don't pressure them through. But with a good sharp chain, these things work really good. And like I said, this one here has really been handy. A lot of your low hanging limbs, I just put my generator here in my little trailer behind my lawnmower or behind my side beside, and you can just run around and do your limb trimming. And if you got any up high, you can stick it on your pole here. But now I'm gonna attach that clip. And after y'all watch some of this video, if you would like, I'm gonna have the link attached above where you can go back and watch the original review I done on these. Alright guys, gonna have to take me a little water break. I got a couple more little limbs they want to cut on this side. That pretty much does the limb trimming. Like I said, I'll get back over here with my tractor and my forks and we'll pick all this up, take it out there. They got a spot they can sack it and burn it. Got some dirt to spread for them. Main part of this video is I just wanted to show the little 10-inch electric work saw, how good it works, how much you can do with it. And guys, this ain't a small percentage of what I've cut in the last 2 years with that little Worx 10-inch chainsaw and pump saw. They really worth their money as long as you understand they're not going to cut and run like a gas operated. You gotta let them just do their own timing as they cutting through. Don't try to force them. But anyway, I hope you liked this little video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. If you haven't never subscribed, please click that subscribe button at the bottom. It'll really help me grow this channel.